Undeterred by criticisms, the Philippine Defense Department stands by its decision to terminate a long-standing agreement that prohibits any military or police presence inside the campuses of the University of the Philippines. DND Secretary Delfin Lorenzana insists a 1989 accord with UP has become obsolete. He even described the country's premier university as a safe haven for the enemies of the state and a breeding ground for extremism. Lorenzana also slams the alleged special treatment being given to UP. But for UP President Danilo Concepcion, the move is totally unnecessary and unwarranted. While UP's Vice President for Public Affairs, Dr. Elena Pernia, hits a lack of consultation before the deal is scrapped.
It's a unilateral abrogation, a unilateral termination. So what it has caused is misunderstanding and mistrust.
No?
So talagang, you can expect our constituency, our community, you know, to be really worried,
you know, because
we don't know what will happen. We don't know, exactly how the military can enter.
UP officials now call on the Defense Department to revoke its termination of the accord.
President Rodrigo Duterte supports Defense Secretary Delfin Lorenzana's move to terminate the UP-DND accord. That's according to Duterte spokesman Harry Roque. Should the abrogation push through, Malacanang reminds government troops, warrantless arrests are not permitted during student protests at the UP campus. It also assures critics, calls for Secretary Lorenzana to reconsider the revocation of the agreement will be heard.
Na kailangan magsalita pa po ng mas malinaw si President Danilo Concepcion nang malaman ang kanyang paninindigan at kung ano yung mga dahilan kung bakit dapat ma-reconsider yan.
The UP community denounces what it describes as an attempt by government to suppress academic freedom. Student Regent Select Rini Ko says the move to terminate the 1989 UP-DND Accord is akin to spitting on the graves of past UP students who resisted the militarization of their campus. For the alumni of the university's official student publication, the Philippine Collegian, ending the agreement will open the gates for further harassment and suppression and erode hard-won democratic spaces. They also believe the issue is meant to divert the public's focus from other pressing issues. Meanwhile, protests were held at the UP Diliman campus Tuesday. Students, as well as university officials and activist groups, were in attendance.
There have been many cases of AFP and PNP violating this accord. In the recent months in UP Cebu, there were 8 students arrested by state forces on the campus while the UP-DND accord was still in effect. It is very against the demands and immediate needs of the students for a more accessible education amid the pandemic. Why are they focusing on militarizing our campuses?
For UP Professor Danilo Arau, government's move to terminate its deal with UP should not have come as a surprise. But he says due process was not observed. He says a group monitoring the compliance of the accord should have first made a report before the agreement was abrogated.
Yung mensahe natin sa publiko, ngayon UP yan, sa susunod baka PUP na. At yung iba pang mga universidad na walang kasunduan, mas lalakas ang loob ng militar at ng pulis dun sa paghahasik ng karahasan.
For UP Professor Marichu Lambino, the termination of the agreement is meant to destroy the image of the university.
Para ho sa kabatiran ni Defense Secretary, wala pong sadyante ngayon sa UP campus. Wala rin pong faculty dahil online class po kami lahat. Hindi ko po alam kung ano ang pakay nila. Baka po ang pakay nila ay siraan yung reputasyon ng UP at palabasin na kung ano-anong kalokohan ang nangyayari.
Students should be able to criticize the government without fear. That's according to Sonia Soto, former chairperson of the League of Filipino Students and the signatory in the accord with the Defense Department. But with the termination of the agreement, Soto says it is now the youth's turn to defend their institution, just as her generation did 40 years ago.
I think this is the more important thing, no? Kasi yung accord, yung mga agreements na yan na naging resulta ng dialogue, ng negosasyon, ng pag-uusap ay hindi binigay on a silver platter, no? Ipinaglaban yan ng mga estudyante, ipinaglaban ng mga nauna pa sa atin, di ba? Naalala ko nga, ang pinag-uusapan noon, anong mangyayari sa mga estudyante? What is going to happen to us students, to us young people, if we were not allowed to think, to be critical about what's going on, to speak our minds? What anong kwenta ng pag-aaral ng edukasyon, hindi ba? So noong panahon na yon at panahon ngayon, noon at ngayon, pareho pa rin. Kailangan pa rin bigyan ng kalayaan ang kabataan na makapag-isip, na matuto ng walang takot.
Now, how could the termination of the UP-DND Accord impact activists? We now have AJ Lagrimas, spokesperson of Anak Bayan UP Diliman. AJ, hi.
Hello po. Good afternoon.
AJ, you've heard the criticisms of the termination. And Anak Bayan views this move as a means by government to repress academic freedom and youth activism. What do you think is the most immediate effect of this termination to your group, to Anak Bayan, to other groups, and to youth activism in general?
Let's go back to the fact, Nona. The UP-DND Accord was not given to us in a silver platter. It was born out of blood, literally blood and sweat, of the former activists who were present in the first quarter storm or even under the Marcos's dictatorship, no? And nakikita natin na kung patuloy itong tatanggalin sa atin, yung UP-DND Accord, hindi lang siya panimulang attack, hindi lang siya ultimate attack to the students of the University of the Philippines. It's a signal to a more brazen attacks against the Filipino people. So nabalitaan natin, no, sa bisa ng National Task Force to End Local Communist Armed Conflict, patuloy silang nanared tag ng mga organizations. And kasama na nga doon yung Anak Bayan. And Anak Bayan is an organization inside UP Diliman. So if ganito ka blatant yung red tagging laban sa mga kabataan sa loob man o labas ng University of the Philippines, it's really an...
AJ? Okay, that's AJ Lagrimas of Anak Bayan UP Diliman. We don't seem to have a good connection with him. We'll try to call him back later on in the newscast. Denise?
Several high-ranking officials voiced their opposition to the Defense Department's move to end its decades-old agreement with UP. Vice President Lenny Robredo says the termination of the deal was clearly meant to silence government critics. She adds if government's real intention is to enforce the law, then the military only needs to notify officials at UP before conducting operations within its campuses. For Senate Minority Leader Franklin Drilon, the move will not solve any problem. He says it would only result in heightened tension between the UP community and state forces. Senator Francis Pangilinan, meanwhile, echoes sentiments by UP officials, saying the Defense Department must have held dialogues first before making such a decision.
The 1982 Enrile Soto Accord was government, a dictatorship, negotiating and signing an agreement with students. Why? Because they realized na they could not suppress student unrest with arrests and harassment. They had to sign that accord. So that the protests and the boycotts would stop. I hope, magkaroon ng dialogue. Baka sakaling may salba pa, diba? Of course, my other concern is this is a divisive issue. We have yet to address COVID and its spread. We are still discussing issues about the most effective vaccine and the rollout. The economy is in doldrums. 100 millions are hungry because we have not been able to manage the spread of the disease effectively compared to Thailand, Taiwan, Malaysia, Singapore. Sana yun ang tutukan natin.
Kabataan Party List Representative Sara Elago also slammed the scrapping of the deal as she stressed the role of academic institutions in upholding human rights and democracy. While for House Deputy Minority Leader Carlos Zarate, the cancellation of the agreement is a continuation of the Duterte administration's crackdown against those critical of its policies.